in God. Trust in Jesus, He will never let you down. Trust in Jesus, trust in God. Trust in Jesus, He will never let you down.
The Bible tells us of the story about the woman with the issue of blood. Specifically, the Bible says that she had been around for 12 years with a situation that was incurable. Not only was it incurable, she also spent her livelihood on physicians, and there was absolutely nothing they could do. But one fateful day, she came across a man that she had heard was not an ordinary man, a man who had the touch of God upon him, a man who we found out was actually God. And she had that faith to say, if only I could touch the hem of his garment. Now see, faith is not just in words alone, it's not just in your thoughts alone, it's also in your works. So she took that step, regardless of how she was feeling, and she went and she touched the hem of his garment. And something stopped. The flow of blood stopped absolutely immediately. And Jesus saw that and said, someone touched me. And then we got to hear her testimony. I want to tell you something special. God can reach you wherever you are. No matter what the situation is that you're going through, He can reach you. All you have to do is take a step of faith. Lord Jesus, I need a touch from you. You can touch Him through His word or touch Him through somebody else that has a touch from Him. I know we can trust in Jesus. Hallelujah.
Trust in Jesus. Trust in God. Trust in Jesus, He will never let you down. Trust in Jesus, trust in God. Trust in Jesus, He will never let you down.
Now there's another story of a young man called Nathan. While his mother was pregnant, right here in Cornerstone Christian Church of God, her water actually broke and she went to the hospital with her husband and a mother. Now what happened was, little did we know that the umbilical cord was tied around the neck of the baby. So when they went to the hospital, they sent them back home saying her water had not yet broken. And they were shocked, they were surprised, but they kept on praying and trusting. A few days went by and they went back again to the hospital. Now this time, the doctor said, you know what, we don't have a choice, we just have to begin to, you know, induce labor. Now as she began to push, the doctors noticed immediately that the heartbeat of the baby was dropping. And right there and then, they realized that the umbilical cord was wrapped around the neck of the baby. Now see, if they had not noticed that, if they went a few days prior, most likely that baby would have died. Jesus knows your end from your beginning. Every single situation is designed for you in mind. The mother's life was spared and the baby's life was spared. Now there's another situation in the Bible in the case of Lazarus. Now Lazarus died for 4 days. And the Bible said, Jesus knew he was going to die. Jesus knew he was sick, but allowed all that to happen. And Jesus went to the graveside where he actually was. And he shouted at the top of his voice and said, Lazarus, come forth. And the Bible says the one who died for 4 days came forth. Now, there is nothing that God cannot do. Anything that has died in your life, I command them to come back to life in the name of Jesus. If you're not born again, you can go to God right now and say, Father, dear Lord Jesus, I accept you into my heart. If you're born again and you need a miracle, receive your miracle now in the name of Jesus. I know, I can trust in Him. Let that be your song from now on. You know, I know, we know, we can trust in Jesus. Hallelujah.
Trust in Jesus. Trust in God. Trust in Jesus, He will never let you down. Trust in Jesus. Trust in God. Trust in Jesus, He will never let you down. Trust